up for Amy, it sure would.
Well, it's official. I'm the palest person in South Florida. I didn't even enter a contest or anything. Just some mean girls at the beach handed me a certificate. I'll tell you a little bit about myself. I'm a dancer. I know what some of you are thinking. She just said she's a dancer, but does that really mean she's a stripper? Well, I studied ballet, modern, and jazz. I have a Bachelor of Fine Arts degree in dance, and I performed on cruise ships. I danced in the production shows, earning a living while traveling the world. And I did it all with my clothes on. So no, I'm not a stripper, but I understand the correlation. You know, you hear dancer, you think stripper. But I'm not alone. I've realized there's actually a lot of jobs out there like that. For example, you hear camp employee, you think sexually confused teenager, right? Massage therapist, prostitute, NFL player, murderer. So there's a few there. But I was a professional dancer for 10 years, which means that for 10 years I was starving, but I looked fantastic. Dance is weird. It's one of the only jobs you can have where it's okay for your boss to call you fat, and they will. I was weighed in once a week. They made me step on the scale and they'd record my weight. And if I gained more than 5 pounds, I'd be put on a weight warning and I could be fired. So I had a few tricks on my sleeve to help keep the pounds off, you know? And they're just simple diet tricks anyone could do, really. For example, food substitutions. I love pancakes, but instead of pouring maple syrup all over my pancakes, I might substitute Ipecac syrup. That way, I get a delicious pancake breakfast without all those pesky calories. Plus, vomiting's a great ab workout. Forget that. But once I stopped dancing, it was really easy for me to gain weight. So now I'm trying to get healthy again. You know, I'm working out, I'm meditating, I'm mixing a little meth in with my Nutribullet. Look, I'm trying to lose weight. I'm not trying to win the war on drugs. But I'm trying to get healthy, so I've switched to red wine. Drinking wine can be very sophisticated. I've been learning about wine pairings, and I've discovered that red wines pair very nicely with my self-loathing and shattered dreams. Whereas in contrast, I find white wines pair better with Vicodin. But now that I'm a retired dancer, it's really hard for me to be a stay-at-home mom. Because I don't have any kids. Or a husband, so I have to work, or I'd be on the streets. The women's movement didn't liberate everyone. I do have a boyfriend, though. We've been together for about 3 years. We don't have any plans to get married anytime soon, though, but in all fairness, I knew from the beginning he had a fear of commitment because he doesn't have any tattoos. Well, it's just easier for people with tattoos to get married and have kids because they're used to making mistakes they'll regret. I don't want you to worry about me. I am working, living the dream, waiting tables. It's great. Lucky for me, I have a passion for cutlery and folding napkins. And a desire to provide slow and unpredictable service. Nightly, so. But believe it or not, waiting tables wasn't my first choice as a new career option. It turns out it's tougher to break into the prostitution business than I originally thought. Did I say prostitution? I meant massage therapy. Always do that. Thank you, everyone. Have a great night.